Okay, this video is going to be about rearrangements at oxygen, and it's all about the oxidation of ketones to esters using the Baeyer-Villiger oxidation. So a ketone can be treated with a peracid. So this is a carboxylic acid that has been turned into a oxidizing species by making this OO bond. So it's a peracid or percarboxylic acid. The treatment of a ketone with this type of oxidant leads to esters, and the side product is simple carboxylic acids. So the accepted mechanism for this is that firstly, the ketone is made more reactive by being protonated by the carboxylic acid, or the peracid. Like that. So we end up with a reactive protonated carbonyl group, and then the side product of that is going to be the conjugate base. Okay, and we can draw a mechanism where this then attacks that activated carbonyl group through this kind of curly arrow, and then electrons flow out onto here, and we end up with an intermediate. So this intermediate has a weak oxygen-oxygen bond, and that can break along with migration of one of these two R groups. So let's take R2 here. With its pair of electrons, it's going to migrate to one of these oxygen atoms, and the leaving group is going to be a carboxylate, which is a pretty good leaving group. Okay, so if you follow those curly arrows, we end up with a species that looks like this, except we're missing a charge. So what we can do with this migration is we can assist pushing some electron density in from that oxygen there, and so we end up with a protonated ester group, like so, and our leaving group was this carboxylate. Now, to get from this to the product, there's just a simple proton transfer, loss of H+, and we end up with the product ester. Now, there's two R groups in the case of a ketone. If it's an unsymmetrical ketone, there's a choice between which one of those groups will migrate, and so you can get different possible products out of the reaction. So there's a general rule of thumb that we go in the order of carbocation stability. So tertiary groups transfer more readily than secondary groups, and they transfer more readily than primary groups, and then last off are methyl groups. Okay, but there's one little wrinkle in this, and that is that aryl groups, like benzene rings and similar rings, are around the same aptitude of migrating, same migratory aptitude as secondary alkyl groups. So most of this trend is related to how well that group can stabilize a positive or a partial positive charge. But you might like to think about why the aryl groups are thrown in this region here amongst the secondary alkyl groups. Okay, so that's the Baeyer-Villiger oxidation. Very useful way of turning ketones into esters using these peracids. Thanks for watching.